मयाध्यक्षेण प्रकृतिः सूयते सचराचरम् हेतुनानेन कौन्तेय जगद्विपरिवर्तते।
मया अध्यक्षेण बाय माय अथॉरिटी प्रकृति नेचर प्रोजेक्ट्स गिव्स बर्थ टू द मूविंग एंड द अनमूविंग सचराचरम। चराचरम इज एन इडियोमैटिक कंस्ट्रक्शन विच मीन्स द होल वर्ल्ड consisting of the moving and the unmoving. And then he says, thus the world is set in motion, O Kaunteya. So it is prakriti, again, vasanas, that produces the moving and the unmoving. Brahman is merely the witness, the supervisor. So what is happening here is in verses 7 and 8, he says, I create the beings. So he takes on the creatorship, the doership. In 9, he slowly introduces the concept of unperturbed, unattached. I do it all, but I'm unperturbed, unattached. And in 10, in this verse, he completely shifts the entire responsibility to Prakriti. He says, I do nothing. I only am the enabling force. I am the facilitator by my authority, my maya adhyakshena. It is prakriti that projects, it's prakriti that produces, it's vasanas that produce. I have nothing to do with it. It is exactly like a catalyst in a chemical reaction. This is a beautiful example. You know, those of you who've studied chemistry understand that in certain chemical reactions, chemical A and chemical B react with each other only in the presence of a catalyst. Minus the catalyst, there is no chemical reaction taking place. But the catalyst does not participate in that reaction. The catalyst merely exists. In the presence of the catalyst, all this furious activity takes place. And Brahman takes the position of a catalyst. Atman takes the position of a catalyst and completely shifts the responsibility to prakriti, vasanas, because for the simple reason that if God had created the world, then he's done a pretty messy job of it. So God could not have produced the world, because even you and I can produce a better world than this. Then what is happening? God or Brahman is merely the catalyst, and what is functioning is the vasanas. So it is your own vasanas. So from this verse, what we understand is, it is we have to take responsibility for our own lives. We can't sit there and say God does everything. God doesn't do anything. God merely facilitates everything. You have to take responsibility. You have to be accountable for your actions. And you have to make sure that you find your own salvation, because there is no God anywhere who is going to give you redemption. In a way, it's a frightening thought, because then you understand it all depends on me. In another way, it is a soothing thought that yes, you understand that whatever mess I've got into is my own creation. But you also know that I now have the power to bring about my own salvation, redemption. Thus the world is set in motion. This parivartan, this viparivartan, evolution, change, transformation that takes place at the cosmic level. You've heard of black stars, huge stars that suddenly go into annihilation, and suddenly out of nothing, stars come into being, whole galaxies come into being. Same thing happens at the organic level, it happens at the human level. So the whole world is in constant motion. And this motion is created by vasanas. The enabling power is Brahman, Atman, God. He puts things in their place perfectly. Next verse.